Okay, hello my friend, and then information to you that what is vacuum pump in BMW's valvetronic and Vanos engines, and why we need that pump in our car. And let's go to look where is this pump and how to replace that and why we need that. Okay, and now when we are looking this BMW's gasoline engine, we can see in that one side in here, where is this gearbox area, that there is small hose in here. And this part, this hose, goes to our brake master cylinder. And let's go to look next is my brake master cylinder. Okay, and then when we look this my brake master cylinder, and there is this brake fluid area, and just in hidden in here, there is this hose location. And let's go to look that next. And just in here, there is this hole, and in that position in here, this hole in here, what we can now see, there came hose what goes to this my engine's vacuum pump. And let's go to look this pump next, and we need really this pump for that our car's brake force. And we need that pump that if we have any issues in our brake force, that it is very hard or stuff or harsh, then we need to check also that brake master cylinder and also this vacuum pump. And let's go to look that how to replace that and how to repair it. Okay, and here is really this vacuum pump, and we can replace that pump so that first we take this cylinder head cover, this plastic area, away, and let's go to look that how it happens. And this cover replace is very easy. First I take this canister cap hat away, and then I can remove the plastic cover, and then there is the cylinder head, and there is only like 10 small bolts in these sides. And when I take these all bolts in that areas away, the cylinder head cover is plastic and it is really easy to read. And then we can see this our engine area. And then when we look that area in here, there is this my pump, is this area. And for that pump opening, I can take that totally out in this way, that there is two bolts in here. And when I remove these bolts, I can take this metallic part away, but now I have to open first bolts in that side. Okay, and then I need this 10 millimeter socket, and then there is three 10 millimeter bolts, first one in here, and second in here, and I start my job in here, that, and there is three similar bolts, and they looks like that, standard bolts. And then we can look closer this bolt when I am removing it in here, that one, what is in this side. And then I insert my socket in here, in this way. And bolt is free, and then final bolt is in here, low area, in that area. And now, when these bolts are free, then I can take this cover out in that one. And let's look at how it happens. First this bolt away, and then when I little bit move that, now I can remove that whole cover. And there is this axle and shaft what moves in same way with this camshaft in here. And then we can look this inner area, because it is really interesting. And now I insert this my pump in back in position, and look, it goes only in one way in there. And then I need next tool that I can open this area. Okay, and then I need this specific tool what is in my hand. It is like Torx tool, look at sides and type. It is like six corner tool, and there is then this message in here. It is TX20 is this type, and it looks like that, and this type fits in these vacuum pumps covers holes. And now I use again this electric drill driver, and I open, and opening direction is for that way, and there is one just specific screw, look, it looks like that, and this tool fits directly in here, look. Okay, and then we can go to look a little bit closer. Okay, and there is next bolt, and we can see that how this my drill driver opens it. And now it is free, and then we can look when I took away this next. Okay, good. And now this all bolts are free, and now this cover opens, look. This is cover, and maker is LUK. And there is another side. And in here is this really interesting vacuum pump. And let's go to look that closer. Okay, and then there is this vacuum pump, and it really works so that when camshaft is moving, then this part is moving also. And look this movement. This is so interesting. It goes like not in... It goes in these sides, and idea is that when this moves in that way, firstly it takes intakes air, and then when this pump is moving, it like intake air in here, and then it makes this braking force, and then it all time moves and in this way, and then it releases this air away in here. And this is like, it generates pressure in that way. And then we can take that whole part away, and we can see those gaskets. And here, when we look that closer, there is really these gaskets in here. These small metallic pins in here, look, what goes in indirectly in here on both sides, and there is also this oil lubrication, and this is really interesting device. And then in here we have this axle where this part goes, and this part is all time moving, and now this my gasket drops to ground, but I can take. And look how nicely it moves, and there is this connection points to camshaft, what makes this movement. And there we can see that there's also good oiling points and air what goes in that area. Very nice engineering. And there is this hole where we have this engine oil what lubricates that movements. And this is really this BMW's pump, and there can be those issues that we need to replace these gaskets in here, look, they can burn out. And then there is this rubber gasket in that outer side, and let's go to look that area next. Okay, and then when I have this sharp hook, I can take out this gasket in the sides that I insert this hook in here, and sometimes this gasket, this is leaking, this part, look. And we need to only go to then visit in BMW's this spare part center, like shopping store in USA, and then we can get new gasket in here. Okay, that kind of information, my friend. And thumbs up.